One thing I've learned from my time on the interwebs is that it's really easy to push people's buttons.
What a fucking nigga.
Basically, if you want to start a controversy, it's not going to be hard to do accidentally. Now, what if you do it intentionally? I remember first hearing about hatred in 2014 when it was announced, and I was pretty interested. The concept was hilariously edgy, but admittedly, I was morbidly curious to see what kind of game we'd be getting. The trailers were geniusly designed to be as horrific as possible. I'd even argue they're some of the most iconic game trailers of all time. It only got better when the game received an AO rating from the ERSB. Yeah, AO, as in worse than M. In other words, the ERSB indirectly claimed that hatred is more violent and graphic than Grand Theft Auto, Mortal Kombat, God of War, and just about any video game that was ever rated M. The only other game to be rated AO for violence alone is Thrill Kill, but that's tamed by today's standards. Also, hatred was banned from being streamed on Twitch. In other words, hatred was stacking out to be possibly the most violent game ever made. Then the game came out and it got mixed to negative reviews and was mostly forgotten. However, could there be some good that was overlooked? Let's find out. You play as this really edgy guy named the antagonist, even though he's technically the protagonist. But everyone just calls him not important because...
My name is not important.
Not important basically decides it's time to kill everyone, and I do mean everyone. He just steps outside his house and starts shooting every person he sees. You guys might be thinking, what's so violent about this? You could kill civilians in GTA or really any open world game. And the gore is honestly tamer than even Hotline Miami. So why is this so controversial? The only real answer I can think is that the game requires you to murder civilians. GTA never explicitly tells you to gun down innocent people, but hatred does. I don't understand either, but apparently all you need to do is put a kill counter on unarmed opponents and your game goes from bestseller to be banned from every console and most retail stores. Although I've heard that hatred might be coming to the Switch. I guess Animal Crossing isn't for everyone. Hatred is a top-down shooter very reminiscent of the first Postal game. I honestly can respect them for making this a top-down shooter as opposed to an FPS like everyone else does these days, although we'll get to that. The controls are the first thing you're going to notice about this game, and it's one of the biggest complaints I've heard. For whatever reason, Non-Important's movement is entirely independent of his aiming, which means he will not walk into the direction he's aiming like characters do in most games. I know this game is technically meant to be played with a controller, but it was released on PC, so you should be able to play it with a keyboard and mouse. Another issue is the aiming, which always seems to spread way too much. You can crouch to aim better, but I feel like Non-Important should be a slightly better shot. You have the ability to vault over small fences and obstacles, and you need to hit it so specifically. If you're off by an inch, you gotta turn your ass around and try again, which isn't exactly easy when you're being shot at. The only way to regenerate health is by executing downed civilians or enemies, where an animation will sometimes play of Non-Important fucking the poor soul up, and then he says something really edgy right after. I'm not gonna lie, these aren't very well animated. Sometimes the movements are a bit stiff and look a little ridiculous. Also, sometimes you can kill people and they die immediately, which will not give you the chance to execute them. While I initially thought that blowing off their face at close range is what caused this, the more I played I realized it was just completely random on how they determined when someone would die or just be badly injured. I guess it's more realistic that way, but it's the only way to regain health. It should be consistent. At least with the newer Doom games, you have a way to get health outside of the glory kills. With hatred, you have to do the executions to get health. Once the police arrive, you suddenly realize something about hatred. It's really fucking hard. And not in a good way. There'll be so many times where you'll be shot in numerous directions by assholes off screen. Thankfully, a mini-map exists to tell you where enemies are. You also have the ability to aim farther, but this causes the camera to shoot off in whatever direction you're aiming in, which can sometimes mess you up. You gain respawn points when doing objectives, which are basically like lives, but if you run out of them, then you have to redo the entire level when you die. On harder difficulties, this game can be nearly unplayable. Thankfully, the AI is dumber than dirt. The civilians don't seem to understand what angry man shooting everyone with a gun means, and the cops can easily be cheesed by hunkering down inside a building and they come in one by one. Something I really love about this game are the throwables. You get grenades, molotovs, and flashbangs, and I have no criticism for them. I never had a problem throwing them and getting them to land where I needed them to land. They're powerful and effective, and best of all, they can destroy the environment. That's another thing I love about this game. The destructible environments are really cool. Although there is a strange amount of things that just can't be destroyed for some reason, but being able to blow up houses and utterly decimate everything is amazing and really gives off the feeling of being this destructive force. However, the opposite happens during the gunfights. Not Important just doesn't feel like he's built to fight the overwhelming amount of enemies. The first level is called Home, where Not Important steps out of his house and begins rapidly shooting at anywhere in his path. It's for the most part very straightforward. There's a specific amount of people you have to kill to progress, but civvies and cops keep respawning. On one hand, it means you don't have to hunt down the last person in the surprisingly large levels, but it also makes Not Important seem lazy. I thought his intention was complete genocide, yet I guess he just says, that's enough. Anyways, the next level Not Important hides in the sewers. Why? Because every fucking game needs a sewer level. It's kind of surprising they went right to the sewers in level 2. You'd think Not Important would be looking to shoot up more of the city. This level is obviously more cramped than the previous one, and it's much more linear. You make your way through and fight the SWAT team. I honestly wonder why they even came after him instead of just waiting at the exits for the sewer. Granted, technically any manhole could be an exit, but I don't exactly know if police protocol involves chasing an active gunman into a place that gives them a tactical advantage. There are no civilians here other than some drug addicts that just lay around that you can shoot to get some health, but overall a much more forgettable level than the last one. At least it's short, you know? After you exit the sewer, you immediately begin murdering everyone at the marina. Very convenient that everyone's hanging outside in the pouring rain. Other than the scenery change, there's not much to say about this level, so I'll just talk about our hero Not Important instead. I'm not gonna lie, this guy is fucking hilarious.
Your family won't cry for you. They won't survive that long.
I imagine the developers were self-aware with this guy because it'd be kinda sad if they actually expected us to take this dude seriously. Basically, Not Important is this super edgy guy that just says a lot of edgy things. However, it's clear he has no real plan. For fuck's sake, he just walks out the door and starts shooting. You can even tell he's just as surprised as you are that he managed to succeed in this killing spree instead of getting gunned down by the police in the first 6 seconds, and it's honestly amazing. After the marina, Not Important hops on a convenient train and takes off. Obviously, he's gotta kill everyone on the train while he's there, I mean, come on. Not Important also realizes the next train station is near a nuclear power plant. I'm sure you can figure out where this is going. You actually do fight a handful of armed civilians, because this is America after all, but for the most part it's a pretty easy level. Everyone is all lined up in a straight corridor, so it's like shooting fish in a barrel. There's a lot of people in seats that you just forget about or don't see, so ironically not trying to run or fight back is the best way to survive this guy. Also, for some reason, cops and military are on the train. Anyways, you stop the train by murdering the driver, whose headphones cancel out the sounds of gunshots and explosions. And then you get to the truck stop where you start slaughtering more innocent people. There's not much to say about this level either, so I guess I'll talk about the weapons. You get a few weapons like an AK-47, an MP5, a pistol, a shotgun, an M16, a rocket launcher, a flamethrower, an Uzi, and a handful of throwables that I already talked about. You will only use whatever enemies are using, as that's where the ammo is found. The only exceptions are in some levels where weapons can be found in buildings or armories. Overall, the aiming feels weird, but for the most part, the guns sound good and are relatively punchy, so all in all, the gunplay isn't terrible. The next level involves you stealing a SWAT armored truck and using it at a train station. The vehicle controls in this game are awful. It's hard enough using an isometric angle, but it gets even worse when you need to aim with it as well. You cannot shoot while driving. Not Important needs to switch between turret mode and driving mode, which makes it hard to kill anyone because they run away by the time you get the machine gun already. It doesn't help that if you crash into something without enough momentum, you just stop. I abandoned this thing pretty quickly as a result and went on foot. There are some cool things you can do here though, like crashing a train, which is pretty fun. The next level begins as you shoot up a political rally, and you can even assassinate the politician. He wasn't gonna win anyway. The game gets a bit harder at this point because they basically hammer you with cops and SWAT units, as well as giving almost every civilian a gun. Eventually, Not Important realizes he needs some explosives to blow up the power plant, so he decides to attack an entire fucking military base to retrieve some. The military base level is awful for many reasons. 1. They spawn you in the shitty armored truck. 2. Everyone automatically shoots at you the second you arrive, so you'll never be able to get the drop on them. 3. There's only one way into the base, and it's through the main entrance. Yeah, I've seen not important drive-through houses, but a chain link fence is too much for him. Four, every enemy shoots at you immediately, so your armored truck only lasts a few seconds. Five, you have to go all the way to the back of the base to retrieve the C4. Six, you still have to leave the base by backtracking to the front. Seven, only a handful of people aren't soldiers, so regaining health is a bitch. The level is not fun at all, and I couldn't imagine doing it on harder difficulties. Not important's aiming, movement, and health are not really built for fighting large groups of enemies. Hell, the game even reminds you that running away from a firefight is a good idea sometimes. I guess nobody told Not Important that, because he just drives his ass in. What the fuck? I originally imagined running past everyone and getting the C4 would be a good idea, but you still needed to go back anyway, so you're going to have to fight them. You also find a flamethrower in this level, which is honestly not very effective or even practical, because you can't execute enemies while you burn them, so there's no way to get help. I honestly don't think there's a viable strategy other than cheesing the AI by shooting them from afar, then driving into the base. The final level is the power plant. The only really difficult part is at the beginning when a platoon of soldiers are waiting for you, so you basically have to do the same thing you did in the previous level to get past them. Once you get inside, you basically just run through narrow corridors fighting soldiers. You can also gun down the staff, but even though it's the purpose of the game, it's almost impractical because you're essentially wasting ammo that you need to use on the soldiers. Overall, this level isn't bad, just mediocre, and not really a very satisfying conclusion. There's no final boss or anything. The ending's pretty funny, though.
How do I overload the reactors?
What? No, never! It will cause a massive explosion! Are you insane?
That's what I want, and you will tell me. Or I'll make you die. Very fucking
Alright, please stop! I will do this! I will do this!
And the credits are honestly pretty badass. So now that the story mode is done, what's left in HP? Well, there's a survival mode. You have three playable characters that you use to survive against waves of police. It's honestly better than it could be, as there are upgrades and perks as opposed to just being an empty map with spawning enemies. There's also a relatively small modding community with a color mod and two camera mods, Mass Murder and Death Dealer. Mass Murder turns Hatred into an FPS, which is kinda cool, but it plays sorta wonky, and you look like Rayman. Death Dealer makes the game a third person shooter, kinda like GTA. It honestly makes the game a lot better. If this wasn't meant to be an homage to Postal, I think it would have been better as a third person shooter. It also makes the driving way better. Overall, the mods are limited, but they're pretty fun. In conclusion, Hatred's a pretty decent game, especially for how cheap it is nowadays. If relatively repetitive gameplay, mediocre controls, and edgy content don't bother you, then it's worth a shot. That being said, this game honestly isn't a good stress ball like many people would think, simply because of the game's difficulty. As a whole, Hatred really was a game that was meant to sell controversy first and be a good game second, and it honestly feels unfinished in some aspects. However, it isn't by any means a bad game, and there is fun to be had. Just don't expect some kind of crazy game that will horrify you with its violence.